Hello everyone. Today we will discuss this topic, stem analysis. It is another important topic for the subject forest mensuration, as you people have to study BSc forestry third semester. And forest mensuration is one of the important subject that one should know, and this topic stem analysis also very important within this forest mensuration. So we'll discuss today this topic, stem analysis. Right. So first we need to understand what is stem analysis definition. Basically we're talking about, so where we need to understand here what is stem analysis. So now we need we all need to understand here that it is a kind of process. This stem analysis, a process of cutting of tree stem into series of sections and by measuring annual rings on these sections to know the past history of tree with regards to its rate of growth in volume, diameter and height. Right, listen carefully again. What does it mean, the statement that I have made, that what do you mean by this definition of stem analysis? Right, so here we have a stem. Right, we have a stem. What we have to do, that we have to through the stem analysis, is just a process that we are cutting all these stem into series of sections and then we are measuring annual rings for each section. Right, and by counting those annual rings we are able to know the past history of tree. Right, and through the past history, what the information we'll get the information of rate of growth in volume, diameter and height. Right, so if you understand this statement, then you can clearly know that definition includes annual rings. So a stem analysis can be only applicable for those trees which has distinct annual rings. So there is a bit restrictions here while using the stem analysis, that can be used only for those species which has a distinct annual ring. So these things you should be kept in clear in your mind. Right, and we can use this technique, stem analysis, both either the tree is standing or the tree is felled. We can use that. For example, if we are using this stem analysis on the standing tree, so what the things we have to do there, so we can use this increment borer. Right, so that we can get this through the increment borer we are able to get this calculation of annual rings through that. Right, and if it's a felled tree, so obviously felled tree is there, so felled tree we can cut the tree into different sections and then we can count the annual rings, and again we'll get the information related to the tree. And again I am repeating what the basic information that we are supposed to draw using this stem analysis. So information is the rate of growth in volume, diameter and height. Is it clear? So so these things that one should understand through this stem analysis. Now you remove this purpose. So objective, so why you supposed to do that? When you understand that this definition of a stem analysis, we must understand the objective or the purpose, why we should do stem analysis. That is important there. Right, so as the definition suggests, through this stem analysis, the concept of a stem analysis or the process of a stem analysis is going to help you to know the past history of growth of trees. Right, as we understand through this definition, isn't it? Through this stem analysis, what we are learning, the past history of growth of tree. Right, and when we get all this information, then our job is to generalize that information. Right, and what the purpose of generalize, so that you can use that concept anywhere for the same species, same site quality. Let me explain in a very simple way. For example, we have a site A. Just look at it. We have a site A having species X, right? And we are conducting a stem analysis in this particular species and this particular site. Is it clear? So then after that, while collecting all this information, so we can generalize those informations, and when you get generalized, so we can apply the same information on the site B having the same quality as site A, right, and same species X. So we can use the information that is gathered at A at this point B also as it is. Is it clear? So through this stem analysis, we are generalizing the information that we have gathered. And what the information we have gathered? Past history of growth of tree. I hope, is it okay to all of you? Right now, as I told you, our job is to generalize. So how the generalization can be made? So by gathering all this information, past information, using the concept of stem analysis, the three things that we need to establish, right? Three relationship need to be established here. So first is age diameter relationship, age diameter relationship, right? Second is age height, age height relationship, right? And the third is age volume relationship, age volume relationship, right? So through a stem analysis, obviously when you're going to count the ring, you are able to get the age, then we can measure the diameter also for the same stem, then we are able to make a relationship between age and diameter. Similarly, age and height, and age and volume, right? And then we are using all these relation to generalize the concept here, and we can apply the same relation anywhere for the same site quality and for the same species, right? So these are the basic information that we are able to draw from the stem analysis. And apart from that, not only this, also we are able to get the information of some external factor also. External factors like flood, drought, lopping, defoliation, etc. All these kind of other phenomena also we are able to understand through the stem analysis. Now we need to understand the manner of tree growth, how the tree has to grow. The manner need to be understood here. So before moving further, before it understand some more concept here, so this manner of tree growth should be understand. It is necessary, right? So that it is necessary to understand the manner in which a tree puts an increment or growth each year. How the tree is putting increment or growth each year. So you just look at the image, this image, just look at all this image here. If you look at there, right, there are three sections has been made, and you need to understand here. So all sections represent one part and one part. So what does it mean? So you just listen carefully, try to understand. So this figure shows a tree in longitudinal section with three cross section taken at different points. As you look at there, different points cross section has been taken over there, isn't it? Right. So from this longitudinal section, what the things has to appear there? As you clearly see in the image itself, it appears that annual rings are layers of wood, isn't it? Annual rings are layers of wood laid on all over the tree each year, right? And you can see that all this laid over to each year, all this woods has been there. Just look at here, isn't it? Right, it's a layer of wood each year. One deposition has been made here, right? And through this cross section, and through this cross section, if you look at the cross section again, and through this cross section at a different height, as we have a different height, we have, you just look at the different height cross section. We are looking just cross section here, right? There are more annual rings. If you look at that, there are more annual rings in lower portion, right? And as we move up, right, or you can say that as the height of tree increases, right, so that there is a reduction of annual ring. As you look at here, this is the base part, more annual rings. As we the height is going to increase, there is a reduction in annual ring that you are able to visualize through this image. Is it clear? So to understand all this manner of tree growth or this phenomenon, how there is a reduction in the number of rings, this fact enables us to measure the rate of growth in height, diameter, and also to calculate the volume of different edges, right? So this is the concept that one need to understand, how the tree has to grow. So again, I am repeating, right, there is a deposition of wood everywhere, a layer of wood, you can say that, every year, and the base. And the base, you will find more annual ring, and while the height is going to increase, and if you move towards the upward side of stem, there is a reduction of annual rings, isn't it? So we need to check this fact, and obviously getting this fact we are able to understand the rate of growth in height diameter, and also we are able to calculate the volume at different stages. Fine. Now moving to this procedures, we need to, there are certain procedures that we need to follow, right? So what are the basic procedures that one need to understand here? So one by one I'll explain you. First, selection of trees, then we have a number of trees, preliminary works have to run, felling of tree, sectioning, cutting of tree stem, counting of rings, additional field work. So one by one I like to explain all this process. So first you have the selection of tree, right? So here there's one thing you need to understand. When you're going to select a tree for a stem analysis, the first thing is there, that tree should not be in isolated condition. First, tree should not be in isolated. Tree should not be in isolation, right? It means first thing, no isolation. Tree should be, no isolation means tree should be properly mixed with the whole crop, right? That is important. Trees, no isolation. Isolated tree need to be selected. Second thing is that the selected tree, whatever tree you have selected, is a proper representative of whole crop. Proper representation should be there for the whole crop. That need to be understand. Again, I am repeating, first you are not supposed to select that tree which is isolated. It means we have to select a tree from that particular crop where all these tree has totally mixed each other, right? So no isolation has to be there. Is it clear? Second thing is that this, that whatever the tree you have selected, that should have a true representation of whole crop. Fine. Then the third thing that we need to understand, okay, what kind of tree should be there. So the tree should be in a typical in shape, size and form. Listen carefully. Typical in shape, size and form, which means tree should be straight. Tree should be straight, free from any disease, damage or breakage. Listen carefully again. What kind of tree you have to select? Tree should be free from any kind of disease, damage or breakage, right? And the fourth thing is that that tree should be of rotation age or more. Tree should be of rotation age or more. The four things that you need to understand while selecting a tree. Again, I am repeating, what are the four things? That no isolation will be there. Is it clear? It means the tree has to be properly mixed with the whole crop. Second, the selected tree should have a proper representation of whole crop. Third, tree should be straight and free from any disease, damage and breakage. And the fourth thing is that tree should be of rotation age and more. So through this process we are able to select the tree, right? After selecting those, using those concept for the tree, how many number of tree is required to conduct a stem analysis or to generalize the result. So it is advisable, right? It is advisable, okay, at least 5 to 10 tree is required of, at least 5 to 10 tree is required to conduct a stem analysis, right? But if it is not possible to get that number of trees there, so at least select one tree, and but you have to be very restricted while selecting the tree. You have to follow all those guidelines that I have discussed in this selection of tree process, the first process I have discussed with you. So you have to follow strictly while selecting, if you are selecting only one tree, right? It means tree should be completely straight, free from any disease, any damage, any kind of breakage, and the age should be more than rotation age of this particular tree. Though it is advisable 5 to 10 tree, but if it is not possible to get this 5 to 10 tree, so at least get one tree with all these property that I have discussed with you when I discuss the selection of tree there. And you have to be very strict if you are selecting only one tree. Is it okay? So through this you are able to you are able to have a number of trees, right? then preliminary works has to be done there. So what is preliminary works? It means occupants when you have select the tree, right? Before felling, see, first selection has been, then felling has to be done. So when you have select the tree, right, before felling, you have to note down certain information related to that. That is preliminary works. Listen carefully again. Once you have selected the tree and then you have to fell it, but before felling you have to collect certain information about that particular tree. So what the information is that need to be collected? So obviously location details, for example, location means longitude, latitude, name of division, range, isn't it, then diameter at breast height, crown spread, crown height, all these things has to be noted down first before felling, right? So these are the preliminary works has to be done there. Again, I am repeating, what the works there, what the information that you have to collect through this preliminary works. So before felling you have to done that, you have to collect this location detail, then you have to write the name of division, where it is situated, then the in which range is falling, then diameter at breast height, then crown spread, crown length, etc. It means all the basic information related to that particular tree has to be noted down in this third step. Is it clear? All the things has to be noted down. And one more important that you have to also do in this third procedure, that when you have done that, so before filling you just mark the breast head point, right? That is important, right? You just mark the breast height point before filling, so that after filling that tree you are able to locate the breast height, where the breast height is. Is it okay? This is very important that one should know here. Then after the filling of trees will be there, filling of tree. Now you have to fill the tree, so you have to fill the tree at normal stump height, at normal stump height. See, generally normal stump height is 25 to 30 centimeter, and you know the stump is the remaining portion of the tree that has been still attached to the ground, right? That is stump. This is stump, and you are filling the tree from this particular portion. So generally the tree has to be filled from the normal stump height, but stump height height of the stump may be variable, right? This totally depend upon the suitability of site or the convenience of tree feller. Again, listen carefully, felling of trees has to be done there, and the felling of trees has to be done at a normal stump height, and this stump height may be chosen as per the suitability of site and convenience of tree feller. Is it okay? So when the tree has been felled, again you have to note down some information. The what information that you have to note down after filling the tree? So you have to note down the total height after filling, total height after filling, then height of first green branch, height of first green branch, then height of the point with a diameter over back 20 centimeter, then next is diameter under bark at the point of diameter over bark 20 centimeter, then height of point with the diameter over bark 5 centimeter, then diameter under bark the point of diameter over bark 5 centimeter, and so on. Through this you are able to collect those information after felling the trees, right? Now we are moving to sectioning. So after felling the tree, we have to sectioning the stem itself. So another important thing that you need to understand here, and here one thing you have to understand, that sectioning means you are not supposed to cut the tree in this fashion, right? These things one should understand here, right? There's the purpose of sectioning is only we have to divide the felled stem into series of section. Listen carefully again, I am repeating, sectioning means to divide the felled stem into series of sections, not to cut the stem in this fashion. Only division has been made there, right? So through this fashion you have to make the division. How the division has been made? So again, listen carefully and try to understand there, right? To start with, so first the thing is that द फर्स्ट पोर्शन लिसन कर दिस फर्स्ट पार्ट राइट बिफोर दैट फर्स्ट वी हैव टू फाइंड द मिड पॉइंट. मिड पॉइंट शुड बी ब्रेस्ट हाइट. मिड पॉइंट शुड बी ब्रेस्ट हाइट. एज यू नो द ब्रेस्ट हाइट इज 1.37 मीटर. वी ऑल नो दैट ब्रेस्ट हाइट राइट. एंड हेयर लिसन केयरफुली अगेन. सो द फर्स्ट सेक्शन शुड बी द डबल ऑफ ब्रेस्ट हाइट. और यू कैन से दैट that the midpoint of first section should be breast height. Listen carefully again. This is the first section. The stem is filled. This is section first. So either use the concept here. Keep, just take the first section. The length of first section will be double the breast height. Or you can say that the midpoint of first section is exactly the breast height. Is it clear? Then after that you have to add 3 meter, 3 meter, and you can making this kind of sectioning. Is it clear? Right, only 3 meter, 3 meter, 3 meter has to be done, except this last section, right? So here in the last section, one important thing that a student should know there, in the last section, if the last section is more than 1.5 meter in length, listen carefully, if the last section is more than 1.5 meter in length, then the last section will be a separate section. Last section will be a separate section. But if it is less than 1.5 meter, then what we have to do? Then we have to include this last section with this previous section, right? So this last section may be 4.5 meter. Is it okay? So last section may be 4.5 meter, but not more than 4.5 meter. Because if it is more than 4.5 meter, it means what? It means the last section is more than 1.5 meter. So if it is more than 1.5 meter, it will be a separate section. But if it is less than 1.5 meter, then we can include the last section with the previous section. I hope you all have understand that. And again, I am repeating, all this sectioning is just an imaginary section. It is a, again, I am repeating, it is an imaginary section, right? We are not supposed to cut the tree at this particular point. Fine. So I hope you have understand this portion also there. Then after that, what you have to do? Then you have to cutting out the stem. See, after section, you have to cutting, right? How the cutting has to be made. So again, listen carefully again. Again, I'm going back to the slide. Here we are making the sectioning, right? Here we are making the sectioning, and then here we have to make the cutting. How the cutting has to be made, you need to understand that. So let me draw the first this stem. Sorry, let me make it straight. Goes. So first we have to section it. So section, as you look at here, I am making the same diagram here, same diagram I am writing over there. So it would be 2.74, right? So then after that we are adding 3 meter in this. As you look at here, just add 3 meter with this. So what will be the height of this? It will be 5.74, isn't it? Then again we are adding 3, it will be 8.74. So how the cutting has to be made, and so on the things has to be proceed, and so on the things has to be proceed. Now after section we have to cut the stem. How the cutting has to be? So we have to cut the stem in the midpoint. For example, it is 2.74, so I told you the midpoint is 1.37, right? So we have to cut the stem from this point, from this position, right? So one piece I'll get there, so we'll get one portion. Now what about this? Again the midpoint, again the midpoint, from here we have to cut another stem, right? So through this we have to follow that. Listen carefully again, that tree stem is to be cut at the midpoint, midpoint of each section. See, this is one section, this is one section, this is one section. So now you have to cut it. So we have to cut at the midpoint of each section. It means the tree has to be cut from here, here, then this midpoint, if it is 3 here, so this is the 3 midpoint, and so on. Is it clear? And after cutting, what you have to do after cutting, you have to record the diameter under bark and diameter over bark. Is it clear? And through this we have to make it cutting. Again I am repeating, I hope if you are unable to understand how the cutting has to be made, so again I am repeating so that the concept should be very clear to all of your mind. First sectioning has to be done there. So sectioning, for example 2.74, and I told you is the just sectioning, is the imaginary work. Then after adding 3 it will be 5.7. now after that I have to cut this stem. So how the cutting has to be made? So cutting has to be made from the midpoint. So obviously midpoint will be this for this section, and mid, and if you take it from here to here, right, so this will be the midpoint. So we have to cut the stem into the midpoint of each section. Is it clear? So I hope the concept is clear now. Now counting of rings is there. So again it's not so difficult task. So counting should be from the how the counting has to be done there. So you just look at here, this is this one center point is there, and this is the circumference, as you able to look at here. Is it clear? So we are counting all these rings properly. So how the things has to be done there? So from the center we are drawing radii, at least 2 radii has to be drawn. You can draw the 4 radii also, there is no issue on that, right? And then you have to count all these rings. I hope the ring is visualized there. You are able to count the ring, and after every 10 year or after 1 decade you have to place one pin there, one pin on all these 4 radii. Similarly after again 10 years you have to place all these 4 radii. Is it clear? All through this we are able to you are able to count the rings here, right? And one thing that you should, you are not supposed to count the ring from this side, you have to count the rings from this side, right? It means from center we are starting counting the rings, not from this outside we are starting counting the rings there. Is it clear? I hope the things has been done there. So from the pith to cambium the things has to be done there. So through this we are able to count the rings, fine. And then after that we have to do certain additional field work. So what the additional field work has to be done there? So we have to, bark measurement has to be done there. So using this bark gauze or by getting one chip of bark we are able to do the bark measurement activity. And then we also try to measure the edge to reach at breast height. So this is one of the important like to discuss there, edge to reach the breast height. So how the this edge to breast height has to be evaluated, need to understand. See, listen carefully again. See, when we are felling the tree, when we are felling the tree, right, we are leaving some stump there, and then we are counting the rings from here. It means you are able to get the edge of tree from this position, but what about the edge of this part, right? This also we should know there. So how the things has to be done there? So from the same locality where you are conducting stem analysis, just you get one seedlings, one seedling of same species having a height of 1.5 meter to 2.5, not more than that, 1.5 meter to 2.5 meter, right? And then you can cut that seedlings from the base, from the ground you have to cut it, and then you have to convert this seedling into 10 centimeter section, 10 centimeter section H, right? And then you have to count the annual ring there, and then you are able to know the edge to breast height here, right? So these are the some additional field work has to be done there. And after that, see, whatever with the things that you are recording, all these procedures, all the information has to be written in this form number 1. All these, as you look at here, serial number, height of section, S section, ring, all this exercise you have done in all these procedures. So all the information has to be filled in this form number 1. So as you look at there is one example, as you are able to see that height of section, diameter of bark, diameter under bark has to be there is just an example so that you can understand the concept here, right? So I hope that you are able to understand the basics of stem analysis and the procedure of stem analysis. And if you have any queries, you can write. Right? So this is all about there. Have a nice day to all of you.